Today's video is a fight. It's sanitizers versus hand washing. Do these sanitizers really work? I see them everywhere, outside shops, malls, markets, and even at apartment gates. And I ask myself, what is in this sanitizer? Is it really effective? Can it be harmful? Hi, I'm Dr. Manoj Bharucha, a gastrointestinal and bariatric surgeon in Mumbai, India. In this channel, I talk about current medical problems and topics to create awareness so you stay well informed. Before we begin, if you're new to this channel, consider subscribing and click the bell icon to stay updated. Yes, a hand sanitizer may zap germs and is so convenient to carry and use, but if your hands are dirty or grimy, it makes the task difficult. Soap and water are best for the dirt and grime. Not only do soap and water clean and sanitize, they are actually more effective at killing a wide variety of bacteria and viruses which may remain unaffected by a sanitizer. Also, sanitizers can't remove chemicals or metallic residue like soap can. Not all sanitizers are created equal. The recommended alcohol content is 70 to 90%. That way, you can make sure of maxing out on the germ killing power per use. The high alcohol content makes it highly inflammable. Keep that bottle and your hands away from flames and very hot surfaces soon after use, and keep children away from them. This is difficult. So keep them away from children, which may be even more difficult. Adulteration, and this is a serious warning. Methanol or methyl alcohol is the commonly used substance which is highly toxic and can get absorbed from the skin. If you have spells of nausea, vomiting, blurred vision, headaches, or even tremors, stop using the sanitizer and talk to your doctor immediately or visit the emergency room of any hospital. Sanitizers are ineffective if your hands are coated with mucus, like after a cough or a sneeze. Hand washing is the better option here. The science here is that the virus gets coated with mucus and more difficult to remove with a sanitizer. As it is, the virus has a capsule of fat so that the mucus just adds another layer of protection to the virus. The fatty capsule can be broken by both the sanitizer and the soap, but mucus is better washed away with the soap. So can you use too much of a good thing? Yes! And too much leads to dry, cracked skin, actually inviting viruses and other germs to enter the deeper tissues and blood circulation of the hands. Some sanitizers have glycerin in them to prevent this, so please use them. And in addition to this, you could be using it the wrong way. Your hands should be free of dirt and grime. Pump 1 to 2 times into one palm. Rub your hands, including between your fingers, till completely dry. That's roughly 20 seconds, or the time it takes you to sing the happy birthday song twice. I don't really have to tell you this, but I will. Don't drink it, even if some president has told you to do so. It is dangerous. If you are a budding chemist or enthusiast, you can make a sanitizer at home. All the ingredients and recipe are given in the description below. When buying a sanitizer, always read the label and instructions on the bottle. It will tell you the right way to use it. A sanitizer is considered to be a drug that can be sold over the counter, so a pharmacy would also be the best place to buy it from. The bottom line should have been the top line. Oh, whatever. Use a sanitizer where hand washing isn't possible. Yes, they are super convenient to carry and definitely have a place in hand hygiene and in conserving water, but just can't replace good old hand washing with soap. Remember, you can't control what you touch or who else touched it before you did, but you can look after your own hands. They are the connecting link between the germs on surfaces and your face. If you've stayed with me this far, here's the best bonus tip I can give you. Keep your hands away from your face and wear gloves while doing those outside chores. They need not be disposable, but they must be washed often. Use the sanitizer freely on them. It can only do some good. But wash them or dispose them off after you have used it or come back home. Let the channel community know about your hand hygiene and how it will change after this. And if this video has given you value, give it a like and don't forget to share it with those who might benefit from it. Your comments, queries and suggestions are invaluable. So please take the time to do so. I am Dr. Manoj Bharucha signing out. Thank you for your time.